Today we celebrate the feast of St. Ignatius Loyola. For all of you who love to watch college football, thank you, St. Ignatius, for bringing us great colleges and great teams. But a few notes about St. Ignatius that I'm not always aware of, and you might find this helpful. St. Ignatius died in 1556. He was a soldier by trade. He founded the Companions of Jesus, or the Jesuits. It was approved by Pope Paul III in 1540. So about 16 years before the death of Ignatius, the Jesuits were approved by the church. He authored the Spiritual Exercises. I've not had yet the pleasure to read those. I need to read those. He founded the Roman College. At his death, the society numbered about 1,000 members. It's rather impressive for that time. In 76 houses in 12 provinces, including Brazil, Japan, India today, the number of Jesuits count about 19,000. They are devoted to the glory, to the greater glory of God. Ignatius is the patron saint of those going on retreat and of military soldiers. Our first reading from Jeremiah today, things are very dismal. Life is very sad. And Jeremiah's looking around, and of course the city has been overrun now, and things are very difficult for the Israelites. And Jeremiah keeps saying, you know, if we just didn't sin, this wouldn't happen. Yes and no. Sometimes bad things happen to us. Sometimes terrible things happen to us. Yesterday, over at Walt Disney World, families on vacation from Fort Lauderdale, and mom, 56 years old, collapses. And I don't know her condition today, but yesterday evening, she was in grave, grave condition. And she will die. Just like that. Now, would someone say the family did something bad? You know, this is because of evil in their family that, you know, mom may die? No. No. Not at all. But reading from Colossians, Paul's letter to Colossians, the first chapter, verse 11, Paul talks about how, with God's grace, we can endure joyfully whatever comes at us. Those are his words. Listen to that again. With God's grace, we can endure, and I like that word, endure, because that's what life is sometimes. We're just making it. We're just getting by. We're just getting day by day by day. We're just getting through it. Paul says we can endure joyfully whatever may come to us. Keep thinking that today now. May I endure joyfully whatever may come to me. Because for very holy people, for good people, very good people, terrible things happen. And for holy people, very good people, it's not just a tragedy that later I can maybe somehow work through or get over. But sometimes their whole life seems to be a huge burden. How can Paul say that we can endure joyfully what comes to us? Because if we are close to God, I think with that grace of God, we can endure just about anything. Anything. Think about it. I see, strangely, in life, people who whine. Not young kids. Adults. It's a judgment, but it strikes me that they whine about some of those trivial things. It's astounding, isn't it? What annoys some people. Did you see what she did? Did you see how she looked at me? Over at Disney World. I have a friend. We're over there. I haven't been to Dismore, by the way, in months. Go figure. Become a member of Corpus Christi. I'll never go again, I'm afraid. God help me. But nonetheless, I was with a priest months ago. The place was very crowded. A lot of burdens on his shoulders. A lot on his mind. Can you see how they don't even get out of the way? They're always bumping into us. Look at that. They're always bumping. I said, hello. The place is packed. What do you expect? I mean, when you come to Israel, it's very crowded. People are going to be bumping you all the time. I know. They're taking pictures. It's okay. It's all right. Brother, you are worried about many, many things. Only one thing is important. You too. You know, when you carry such tremendous burdens at times, then a few around you will whine about foolishness. I guess it's important to them, that's all right. But you just quietly think, wow, if that's all I had to worry about, life would be grand. I would dance, you'd say to them. If that's all I had to whine about, I would dance. But see, with grace of God, we can endure anything. And even the time of Jeremiah, life was very hard. Very hard. And I don't make light of it. But see, had the people been faithful to God, had they been faithful, they would have seen their struggles in a whole different light. And they would have realized there was only one thing important, but to stand and pray.